Okay, YouTubers, this is Joe from Art Alien TV. Now, today, as promised, I have a new gigapan from Jezero Crater by the Perseverance Rover. And this is it here. This is Sol 22, mast right, and this is completely raw. And actually, this set of images, unlike most of the others that we've had, is actually quite clear. As I said in the previous two videos, most of the images we've got from the Perseverance rover so far are very poor quality and very low res and very small images. And you can't see any real detail in any of them and are next to useless, really, for any purpose, whether it's scientific or just wanting to look at things. They're absolutely ridiculous. But this set here, this is from the mast cam, and this set is reasonably good. It's nice and clear and bright, and we can see into the shadows and we can see everything fairly clearly, I would say. So the quality is actually really good. When you zoom in, you can actually see quite a lot of detail in the foreground and in the background up here. Everything is equally in sort of semi-focus. Nothing's in sharp focus, but if it was in sharp focus down here, at the bottom of the image, then we wouldn't be able to see anything at the back of the image. So this is the reason why they take everything in landscape mode, which is slightly soft focus. It means you can see everything, right? Otherwise they would have to take a load of different images and then keep resetting the camera to focus on different areas. So it's a double-edged sword with these rover cameras. Basically, this one is actually really good. This is mast right. The mast left is equally as good, but the others, like the NavCam and the HazCam, are not very good at all. Even though I know that the NavCam is actually a 20 megapixel sensor, they're not using it. For some reason, they're either not using it or they're not giving us those very large, high-res images, okay? I haven't found anything in this image, this gigapan, of any significance. Now, someone's marked something up here, which looks kind of interesting, but it's a bit too far away to tell really what we're looking at. But there's something weird, something very strange there. It's got like a skull or a head on it there, with a nose here and a mouth there, but it's a bit vague. I will take a clip of that in a minute and I'll put it in at the end of the video for you to check out. That was put up by Disclosure, whoever that is. So well done on that spot. I didn't see that. Now, I've been over this image for hours and haven't found anything significant. Now, that doesn't mean there's nothing here. It means that I just haven't found anything. That doesn't mean that you won't find anything. So I'll put links to all these gigapans in the description below and you can come and check it out. You may find something here that I've missed. I've been over this four or five times now and I can't find anything clearly artificial or that looks artificial to me, okay? But that doesn't mean there isn't anything artificial here, because I know for a fact that there is in this general area, because I've already shown lots of artificial things in previous videos before the rover moved, okay? I've got another one here which I briefly showed in a previous video, which is this gigapan. I briefly showed this when I was talking in a previous video last week, I think it was, because I showed those clouds, right? We got these clouds here above Mount Sharp. Now, this is Gale Crater. This is the Curiosity rover, not the Perseverance rover, or Percy, as we call him, right? And this is just above Mount Sharp, this cloud. And this was there for about 4 or 5 days. But it's not rain cloud. It's too high up. This is at an altitude of probably 18,000 feet plus. So it's not rain cloud. These are ice crystals in the upper atmosphere, okay? But what's interesting about this image is all this stuff over here, right? This long gigapan I've done at the top is in black and white. And we've got at one end, we have what I've called the Geiger Goyle on Mont Mercou, okay? This is called Mont Mercou, this structure here, right? Which I've done a few videos of already. And we have the Geiger Goyle just here on top. You can just see him there, right? I've called it the Geiger Goyle because it looks like a gargoyle, right? There it is, and you can see the back of the head here looks like it's joined to this part of the rock behind, right? Okay, you can see a line there. when you look at it here, you've got amazing detail, right? Now, this is a different gigapan. This is 3040, right? That one I just showed you was 3047, which was taken a bit later. So this was closer, a closer zoom of the same area, and you can clearly see that looks like a face or head, a carved head, and it's joined to up to here, okay? You can see that line perfectly clearly. It's definitely there. That line is there. Pay attention to that line, okay? We've also got something weird in front of it here, which I'm going to show you in a minute. But pay attention to this line. It's clearly joined to the back of this thing. If this is a head, I still think it is a carved head. The problem is, when you drive up close to a structure like this, which is quite tall, you can't see on top of it. These were taken from a high perspective, from a distance, and zoomed in a long way, okay? You can see from, we're almost level with it, or slightly above it, looking down across the lake bed at Mont Mercure here, okay? So you can see what's on top quite clearly. There's loads of weird things on top of this, and I do think this Mont Mercure is actually artificial. Because if you look at this image again, you can actually see these are blocks. Now, whether these are carved blocks or concrete blocks, I think they're possibly concrete, or they're carved blocks with concrete over them. This looks like concrete. The weathering on it is very intense weathering here, and all these lateral lines are caused by wind erosion, right? Now, we've got some weird details in here. We've got these slash marks. Now, these are probably cracks, right? But they look a bit like slash marks, like someone's gone up to it with a great big knife and then slashed the hell out of it, right? Now, what would cause that, do you think? Now, I think that's evidence that this is concrete, or a type of concrete, rather than solid rock, natural bedrock. I could be wrong. Perhaps some of you could show me examples of this on solid bedrock on Earth. But I haven't seen any of these kind of weird cracks like this on any of these rocks before. This is different. This looks to me like concrete that's eroded away. And this would explain why we have, like here, parts like this where we have a cross section here, right? This looks like reinforced concrete that's heavily eroded. The outer layer of concrete is eroded away, showing some of the inner structure of the reinforced concrete, okay? Now, I've shown lots of examples of this recently on my channel, and this would explain why we have these weird cracks going this way, when in fact the cracks should be going probably this way, not diagonally down like this. This is the sort of cracks you get in the render, like my old house that I used to live in. The rendering, there was subsidence, so there were cracks in the front wall of the house coming down from the roof, and there was a large crack going all the way down like this, and then there were these smaller kind of cracks coming across the render here, where the building had shifted obviously slightly by a few inches, and the render had all cracked, and it had very similar diagonal kind of cracks like this, which almost look like slashes or cuts, right? Now, this is why, this is the outer layer of concrete that's cracking here, right? Because if you look over here, you can actually see up here that this is a block, right, which is separate from the material behind, because you can see behind it here that there is a gap behind this block here on the right. There's a gap behind it with slightly different coloured rock behind it, okay? So I think that this is a structure that's been built out of concrete blocks, and they're coming apart, and this one has moved to the right and forward, and you can see a gap behind it here. And that doesn't match up with this. It's very different to this here. Not only in colour, but in sort of texture and everything. So this is an outer part, I think, that's split away, and you can see behind it. So that says to me that this is actually an artificial structure, because if this was a solid cliff edge, you wouldn't have it splitting away like that and seeing different material behind like that, as far as I can work out. Right? And also, we have more evidence here of this part shifting. You could actually probably look inside this thing, and there may be a hollow area behind it, because you can actually see where it's cracked here, and there's like a little entrance here, right? So there's some weird details about this, and as I showed before, you can even see on here, from this Mont Mercure, you can even see what looked like an inscription along the side here. There's like a letter D there and another one here. I'm not saying that's what they are, letter D's or anything, I'm just saying it's shaped like a letter D. But I've done a couple of videos on this before showing this, and there's weird objects on top of it here as well, up here. So there's artificiality about this thing. And I wonder whether it's some kind of ramp or something that was built and was maybe joined to some of the other things that we can see in the area, like over here, right? There's the ramp. If you follow over here, we've got another ramp here. So it may have been joined to this ramp here, because this ramp is pointing towards this one up here. So there may be a bridge or some kind of structure here, I don't know, but it's very strange. And in this image, this is incredible, this image. This is Sol 3047, clouds over Mount Sharp's Royal Row. I called this the Royal Row or the Royal Mile, okay, because we have the giant statue of Ares, which over here, right? But we can only see him from the sort of nose up there, right? But this is really good detail on this image, really, really good. Really high detail. You can see the eyes there. But unfortunately, there's a mound in front of it from this angle, so you can't see it that well. But you can see it pretty good here from an earlier Sol. That's who I've called Ares. He seems to have horns sticking out either side. Hopefully, the rover will drive from this spot here near Mont Mercure and drive over to the left here, along here, along this sort of flat bit here, and hopefully we will get a close-up of this ramp-like structure right here, and then we'll also be able to see close-ups of Ares, the giant Ares statue, which is over 100 feet tall. And not only that, as we get closer, we may also see this. Now, you can see this giant statue here, and there's another one here. This one is what I've called the Emperor. Now, I've shown the Emperor before, but basically, you can't see him very well here because he's further away and a long way off, okay? But there's the Mars Emperor here. This is that other giant statue right behind Ares over here. There's Ares, there's his eye, his nose, and his other eye. Over here, we have, just here, the Mars Emperor. You can just about see his long nose, his beard and his mouth there. But the weird thing is, just below it is something very interesting, and you can't see it very well in this image, but I want to get close-ups of this, hopefully, and there's something very interesting. He looks like he's got a body, very round body here, but there might be some other statue or some other weird structure in front of it here, and possibly something adjacent to his head here. It looks like there might be another one next to it. So I'm hoping we're going to drive along here, or at least zoom the camera in, and we will get some close-ups of this stuff from further over here, from over here somewhere. And we'll get a really good view of not only the giant Ares statue here, but also the Emperor, and one or two possibly next to that. So this is getting interesting. The statue thing is up here, and we're just too low down. We're just seeing a similar looking object here that's much lower down on the structure that we didn't see in these other images here. I think what we're seeing is a rock just behind here, just here, that's perched on the edge, and this thing is much further up. And the problem is, if you're down here looking at this, you're not going to see the objects on top. So that may be what it is. I'm just going to show you that up close again, because you can clearly see that that's joined. We've got a lovely line there, which I can't seem to draw today. a lovely line going across there, and it's definitely joined. And actually, if you look really closely, I'm going to darken this up for you, because there seems to be something here. Now, someone did point this out in comments, so thank you for that, whoever that was. But there seems to be another one here, another head with a nose here, and that's an eye. I thought this was part of the ear of this one, but I think it may be in front of it. I could be wrong. Let me darken it up for you very quickly before we go. And that should actually pop out, okay? No, wrong one. Let's go minus, make it dark. Let's go dark again. There we are. Now, if you look carefully, you can see, right, that there is an eye socket here, a nose there, with nostrils, and a mouth here with teeth. Okay, cheekbone here. Top of the head seems to go up like that and back. Right? And we got a sort of chin there, it seems, right? Let me take that off. Now, look at this carefully. Let your eyes adjust to it. And I'll just take all those off. And you can see those teeth right there. Let's go. See the teeth? Just here. One, two, three, four. About five or six teeth there in a row. So what we got here are two heads together, it seems, at least. The Geiger, Goyle there, and another one in front of it, which is very vague and eroded. And it's been smoothed out by erosion by the looks of it. But that's what you can see. You can actually see a row of teeth and a mouth and a nose here. And this looks like an eye socket, orbit, upper lip, chin coming out here like that. Okay. And you can actually see those teeth. Once you've seen them, you know they're there. And if we look at it on the Gigapan, let's look at it with the magnifier up close. And you can see them in here, just about make them out. Even though this is quite pale, you can just about see those in front. Just here. There we are. Teeth there. One, two, three, four, five. About five. There it is. So, as I've said before, you're going to need something like the Hover Zoom magnifier, which you can get for any browser. It's free. Just look it up on your browser and it'll come up. But I think now, looking at this again, I think this is further up. And that other thing, which looks like a shell, lots of people saying this looks like a shell. I'm not saying that. Other people are. This is probably much further down, right on the edge of this thing. And because we're low down, we're at low perspective, we can't see the Geiger Goyle. The Geiger Goyle is hidden further up, just up here. There's some weird stuff going on with this mound here. It looks like there's some sort of hieroglyphs or glyphs on the side of this thing here as well. Just here. There's something weird on this. And I wouldn't mind seeing that up close. We've got some weird structures here along the edge of it, which look artificial. We've got the giant statue here of who I've called Ares, and then we've got the Mars Emperor I've called in, with what looks like some really interesting stuff next to him and below him here. Right? There's his head. And incidentally, I've got the Mars Emperor up here. Right? There he is. There's the chin with the beard and the long nose, the eye there. And it's carved onto the side of this butte. Now, these buttes are artificial, and I've shown that before. And that's what we're seeing here. And there's his head just there. Just there. There's his beard just here. And there's a body coming down. Now, this isn't very clear, so I'll take a clip of that and darken it for you. But it's a long way off. And what I'm showing you here is what we might be seeing, hopefully close-ups of, in coming weeks. Okay? So, thanks for watching, everybody. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. I will see you soon.